Center for Values and Leadership, with its mission of raising and empowering strategic leaders, hosted its 2016 summit focusing on the theme Unlocking the Potentials of Retail Trade in Nigeria. It brought together stakeholders and key players in the industry. The founder of the center, Professor Pat Utomi, in his opening remarks, shared the essence of the forum.
Today, our focus is on that traditional, important exchange of goods between peoples who are endowed differently and therefore can more competitively produce certain kinds of goods. And because those goods are available in different places, exchange through trade has been the veritable way through which mankind has made material progress. Very recently, we have seen, of course, a new pattern that seems to be a rejection of globalization with Brexit, with the election of Mr. Trump in the United States of America, and a few such things. The challenge, therefore, for us is that we need to dramatically improve the efficiencies of internal exchange of regional markets such that the quality of life that trade brings us will remain and will be improved, because we are stuck in a very challenging position today.
Mr. John Adeleke, Executive Director of the World Trade Center Lagos, acknowledged that with the re-emergence of the formal retail trade in Nigeria, regulations were posing a great challenge.
There is an urgency that retail further expands and conforms to meet the demands of an increasingly urbanized population. They also allude to the rising disposable incomes of certain segments of the population. Might I add that given current economic circumstances, if that not be the present case, then certainly one can still allude to the rapidly rising aspirations of those segments of society. And thirdly, that government should try to understand the need to modernize retailing, which I have taken to mean not just by placing the onus of modernization on the private sector investors, but in terms of meeting the policy, regulation, and infrastructure demands also involved. CVL also points to a report prepared by the international management consultancy A.T. Kearney in 2014, which labeled Nigeria along with Gabon as offering the best retail investment opportunities in Africa. My constant fear is that our governments do not always appear to fully appreciate all this. So let me remind us all, and in fact, Dr. Pat Utomi has just done so, that the UTCs, the Kingsways, the Leventices, the CFAOs, the Bosons, they all died, and they died virtually overnight and about 20 years ago. And the reason was policy. So I'm actually sounding an alarm to say, look, if we have the re-emerging formal retail sector is actually under threat, and we shouldn't take for granted that it is here.
Representative of the Managing Director of Nigeria Ports Authority, Mr. Idi Kaba, highlighted the challenge ports were facing in the country.
Several factors have been responsible for making our ports one of the most expensive in the world, which negate the advantage of maritime transport as the cheapest form of transportation of goods. One, insecurity. Although this has reduced in frequency, it has been a very worrisome phenomenon in the shipping industry as it pertains to us in this part of the world. Freight insurance charges go up the moment the cargo is declared for Nigeria. As you are all aware, we have challenges in the Niger Delta, and particularly in the Gulf of Guinea, we have pirates, and that's why the cost of insurance, any goods, any ship coming into Nigeria, the cost of insurance is very high, freight is high, because nobody would like to risk his ship without proper cover, because it's a lot of millions of dollars. So that's why sometimes they find it difficult even to come. Some of the goods we are expecting, they won't come because most of them are afraid that to send their vessels across to this part of the world, particularly in Nigeria when they hear of the Niger Delta. Cumbersome documentation process. This encourages sharp practices resulting to unrestricted charges which are not accounted for, loss of revenue, and increased cost of goods. Multiplicity of agencies. The presence of several agencies in the port add to port cost and delay in clearing. But this government now has taken steps to making sure that we have only 6 agencies that will now attend to your goods in the port, and hopefully by next year the government will going to achieve that, and the cost of clearing will now reduce, because multiplicity of agencies, like the first speaker said, it's there are unrestricted amounts you spend, and of course at the end of the day that ends to the end user of the goods, and that brings up more cost on each of those goods that have been sent to the market. Inconsistency of government policy. This can adversely affect cost of certain cargo in a significant way. For example, the auto policy has caused significant increase in cost of clearing used vehicles as a result. Retail prices of both old and new vehicles have increased because Nigeria is not yet self-sufficient in local manufacturing.
Speaking on financing retail trade in Nigeria, Mr. Lufemi Awoyemi, CEO Proshare, gave insight into the dynamics of retail trade in Nigeria.
Let me try and contextualize the whole idea around this retail trade. One of the problems of definition which we had during the revision was what constituted trade. How do we define retail trade? And most of the times we've confused it beyond meaning that every single activity in this country around merchandising, commerce, or consumption is about trade. But the definition of retail trade is predicated on one singular factor, the fact that it is formal, the fact that the financial systems can recognize the whole ecosystem around that trade and understand how it can intervene at the top end and at the low end. Of the $122 billion trade, which I believe Deloitte assumes our Nigerian market is, less than 2% is done through any of the malls which you have here. And again, for some reason, some people also believe that malls are an urban trade. What ShopRite has done in Nigeria would help me explain to you about what you call financing retail trade in Nigeria. There are two major challenges here. The challenge of migration from the informal sector to the formal sector, which will not happen in the next 10 years because of our cultural issues. And the second is the role of foreign investors who will dominate the Nigerian retail trade market. Every time they talk about Nigeria as the largest consuming market in the whole world, they play around with this figure, right? They say 180 million, a country of 180 million people. But one of the few things they haven't told you really is disposable income within that 180 million. So every time they do the analysis, I say, you can't get it wrong. 100 million, I can sell to 50 million, I won't get it wrong. Early this year, South Africa announced that they're beating Nigeria in terms of GDP size. Who cares? But the real truth of the matter that should concern us is it's not so much of the volume of your GDP, it's relative to the population in your economy. So if we as South Africa run the same GDP, they have about 35 to 40 million people. We have 180. It doesn't make sense. We are less productive as a people than they are. So the fact that you're on 600, or you know, not just the games of numbers, but the real thing where it occurs to us is that how does it translate to trade? Well, it cannot translate because you run a multi-currency type environment. Retail trade and currency risk do not go together. When you talk about promoting agriculture, you basically must be talking about retail trade, because that's where the whole thing will come together. You can be talking about farming and all those things as if you're in prehistoric world, but that's for yesterday's people. Modern thinking is that the anchor for your whole agricultural strategy is about your retail trade. If it's not there, if it's not sitting on it, you're basically a non-starter. You're just dreaming. It's like a bucket list.
A major takeaway from the CVL 4th Economic Sector Forum on retail trade is that policy will play a key role in determining the growth and spread of the entire value chain in the Nigerian retail sector.